Education Superintendent, Principal, and the Athletic Department of Rossford High School would like to welcome you to tonight's game. Woodmore High School and Rossford High School are both members of the Ohio High School Athletic Association and the Northern Buckeye Conference, and abide by the high standards of conduct, competition, and relations with member schools. The officials assigned to this contest have been selected and assigned according to the procedures adopted by the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Tonight's officials are James Priestman, Derek Lewis, and Lucas Speck. The athletes, coaches, and officials are guests of Rossford High School. All fans are asked to respect the effort each of them has put forth preparing for tonight's contest. We ask all attending to show courtesy and respect for fellow fans, officials, coaches, those administrating the contest, and of course, your team and opponent. And as important today as ever, please respect the game. And now let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for the visiting Woodmore Wildcats. At guard, a 6-foot senior, number 2, Paul Kanan. At guard, a 6'1 sophomore, number 3, Aaron Miller. At guard, a 6-foot junior, number 5, Ethan McNair. At forward, a 6'4 senior, number 30, Andrew Behringer. And at guard, a 6'1 junior, number 34, Aaron Sandrock. The head coach of the Wildcats is Aaron Klaus.
There we go.
At this time, we would like to recognize Rossford Junior Cameron Gaston on recently being named the Player of the Year in the Northern Buckeye Conference and also the Player of the Year in the district in Division II.
There
and
we
now,
go.
Fans, stand up and get loud. It's time to meet the starting five. Your Rossford Bulldogs.
Once again, we welcome you here to Rossford High School, the beautiful new gym. And, folks, we got us a great game tonight as Woodmore coming into the house to take on the wonderful Rossford Bulldogs. Mike Jameson here with you enjoying this game. And hopefully you will, too, as we get ready to rock and roll this one tonight. And we got our starters. Everybody's ready to go. We're going to fire this up. We're going to fire that up. And look at that. We got her all ready, and we've got it all set. Gadsden gets it out. I want to make sure I get his name right, too, and what we're doing here tonight. And Sabovic, there we go. I want to make sure. I'm so proud to see him in here in this game. They move that ball around. They're out on the outside. They're going to get it in. Ethan DeWeese with a three, didn't get it. Koenig with it. Is he going to bring it up and set things up for the Wildcats here? And one thing they really have to work on, second or third game that we've seen, turnover right there. Andrew Berenger with a turnover. Andrew's going to have a real nice game tonight. Andrew will take you to the hole. He's a tall, really tall guard, and he plays his position very well. So one of the things they have to make sure that they're going to do here with the Bulldogs tonight is make everything count when they get down there on their side of the basket. Murphy with it, gets it over to Gadsden, and working out with Walker and Perry. And Murph takes it. He misses. How about that? In and out for Perry. And little Euro step there, misses it for Aaron Miller. Still nothing from either side here. See, one thing I have to do, folks, here is I didn't do my time clock very well, and there's a line in the middle of it here. So since I'm here by myself, we'll just have to deal with it, and I'll just have to say 6:44 is what we've got left here. And Zach Hunt in the game, junior for the Wildcats. Still no score. Oh, nice pass inside. Beautiful work there for Nick Perry. Starting out the scoring here for the Bulldogs tonight. We look things over. McNair. Oh, there's another steal. This is Grandpa DeWeese. Grandpa's going to get hit there. Going to take a couple at the line. Like to thank all the great people who have helped us out this whole year. And I know they got the game on over at Moe's right now. Harpo, a lifesaver for us. Thank you, Harpo, for all you do. And the food's great. And thanks for being a part of it. And thanks for keeping our games on live here as we do it. If you want to go over to Moe's right now, they got the game on. First one's up. Got it. Ethan is just one of those kids that just knows what to do, and he knows how to hit the shots. Second one's up. Missed. That ball's all around. Sabovic with it. Murph. Long pass over to Gadsden. Into Perry. They're moving it around really well. Bulldogs are really good at moving the ball left and right and taking advantage of the whole court. We keep looking, and there's Perry again. He misses. Berenger with the rebound. Gets it over to Koenig to bring it up. Basically, at this point, it's all about ball handling. You know, making things happen in the backcourt. There you go. Beautiful shot by Paul Koenig right there. Senior. Gets him on the board tonight. My old buddy J-Dub. J-Dub's watching. He's probably eating a big steak and enjoying all of the comforts of Tennessee right now, watching the game. Thank you, sir. Berenger with a nice rebound again. And, wow, count that. Aaron Sandrock, junior. And beautiful three-point shot. Woodmore takes the lead. That's one thing. Woodmore's got some really good shooters, and if they can get in a rhythm here, can make a lot of good things happen. Another steal. Sandrock with it, and he's going to stay with it. Get it over to Berenger. Up. Oof. Had a little problem on that one. I think he got tipped, to be honest with you. Not that you wouldn't want an honest announcer here, right, folks? with only 2 hours sleep, so I should be fun tonight. I hope Gary Yoder's listening right now, because he'll get a kick out of the fact that I haven't slept today. So Murph with it, and they get it back out to Gatson to reset. Over to Ethan DeWeese. He cross courts it to Murph for a three, and got it. That's all Murph needed was. He just needed to get that ball and make it happen. Beautiful shot right there. Dad would have been proud. He is proud. Look inside, goes all the way to the hole right there. Hunt's going to take that three. Got it. Nothing but net. Something Rossford's going to be really careful about, because all of these guys can hit the top of the rim. Gadsden didn't get that one. Hunter Allen in for the Woodmore Wildcats tonight. Mike Jameson with you. I hope you're having a wonderful evening. The day has just been fantastic. The weather's unbelievable. And tomorrow I'm spending 4 hours from 8 to noon at the Toledo Golf Show on 106.5 ESPN. If you want to listen in to our antics, we basically take over 4 hours of the golf show every year from Andrew Brown. Should be a fun time tomorrow. Like it. Boy, that was a good-looking shot, too, there by Ethan McNair. That's going to stay with the Bulldogs.
Rossman substitutions, number zero, Ben Morrison.
Ben Morrison, Jamari Crooms in. Could be a little different now with Jamari Crooms in, and he'll take advantage. They'll try and take advantage of what's happening, and Jamari has a way of just shutting everything down over there. There's a foul. Looks like it's on Zach Hunt. Yep.
His first personal, team second.
Appreciate y'all listening in right now on the Toledo Sports Network. We love it. They've made us a nice little perch up here, and we enjoy doing the games, and it's just fun. Just fun, even when I'm by myself. To be honest with you, I love being by myself here. You know, I just get to talk and do whatever I want, so. Murph takes it all the way to the hole. Nothing Gadsden for three, and it's in. Nice shot.
Gadsden for three.
We are seeing some serious three-point shooting tonight from both of these teams. Just incredible. First quarter, 2:35. And I'll fix the camera here in a few minutes. Koenig with it again. He gets it out to Miller. I'm sorry, that's Allen. I didn't get that other number. There's a foul.
Rossford foul number five, Jamari Crooms.
Jamari Crooms with the foul.
Team's first for the first half.
Ethan McNair is going to the line. Don't forget, 419-514-1302. You can give us a shout out and tell us what you're doing on this beautiful night, other than listening to this incredibly... Yeah, it's an okay broadcast. You know, what else would you do on a Friday night if you're a Bulldog or a Wildcat fan? Tied up again at 9. First quarter here. We've got about 2:20 left to go. And it could be over at Moe's. You know, Moe could bring me over a Moe burger. That'd make my day. Can't eat after 9 o'clock, Harpo, just so you know that. So, boy, they're moving it nice. Ben with it. Ben sinks
Ben
one in.
For three.
Yeah, we're not seeing a lot of inside play right now, but the threes are flying tonight. Both teams are playing real well with the three-pointer. Betancourt got it, and he's in. They bring it back out. DJ Melter. Over to Koenig. Hunt. They get it back over to Mettler to make things happen. They're moving the ball pretty well. Allen for a long three. He gets his own rebound. There they go. That's blocked out. Paul Koenig to the hole. And Koenig is probably the guy that's going to take the ball to the hole the most. He has the ability and... And once again, you know, one of my phrases of life, you know, you want to learn how to go and play left basketball. You score on the left side. And that's what they're doing right there. A Walker in for the Bulldogs, bringing a little monsterness in the inside right there. Hunt. Nice shot, though. Yeah, it didn't box out, but Gadsden got it. And Gadsden gets it over to Peng. That's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Glenn Forbush couldn't do that good. I mean, it'd be close, but it wouldn't be that good. I'd like to see Glenn Forbush shave his head and get that Ben Morrison look. Not going to happen, huh? No, not going to happen. He's giving me the evil Forbush eye. Nice inside. Got to make them. Meltler took it to the hole. Or Meltzer, I'm sorry, took it to the hole. Just wasn't able to make it happen. Gadsden. Nothing. They moved around Ethan Benn in now. I don't think Ben even hit the ionosphere on that one. Aaron Miller inside. He's going down. That ball's coming back to Rossford. Final game of the season here, and I got a nice crowd tonight. And so far quiet, but nice crowd and a beautiful Friday night. And just glad to have you listen if you couldn't make it. Mr. Ben with it, gets it over to Walker, and he walks. I think he ran that time. He didn't walk. He ran that time. They don't blow the whistle when you run, though. That's the thing. Yeah, they only blow when you walk. Got the bins down in Fort Myers, 57 degrees down there. Well, bins, I'm going to tell you, tomorrow it's going to be in the 50s. That's going to be it for the first quarter here. 14-9 is our score. Rossford on top. You're listening to Toledo Sports Network and ToledoSportsNetwork.com.
At Maumee Bay Turf Center, we're on your team, providing quality stadium surfaces for area high school stadiums and the preferred product of the NFL and supplier to the last four Super Bowls and the NFL Hall of Fame. Your sports field construction specialist and a proud sponsor of high school sports in Northwestern Ohio.
At Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski, we deal with contested wills by breaking down the legal terms involved and making this complex area of law as simple as possible. If you are involved with a case in estate or probate litigation, we would be happy to provide you with our unparalleled legal counsel. Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski, downtown Rossford. Contact them today at 419-662-3100. Heben, Murphy, and Lewandowski.
14-9 is our score right now, and a pretty balanced game so far tonight. Woodmore Wildcats taking on the Rossford Bulldogs tonight. Mike Jamison with you with a play-by-play for you. And Sammy McConowitz from the girls' Rossford basketball team was just presented with the game ball and just has done an incredible year for her. It's not over yet. They've got a game tomorrow night. They're going to be playing at Genoa. And they'll be playing Oak Harbor, so it should be a wonderful game. And I wish we could have it. I wish we could have the game. And Ben Morrison knocks that ball out for the Bulldogs. And but they'll be playing. I think they're at 8 o'clock tomorrow night, right? Yep. Yeah. Glenn just said 8 o'clock. Man, I'll tell you what. Glenn is just. You got to keep him around, man. I'll tell you, he's got his stuff. Oh, what in tarnation was that? Woodmore's having a little trouble with getting that ball and being able to move it around. Now you got Jamari Kroom in there and you got Ben Morrison in there. I'll tell you what, let a lot of the seniors start, and I just give props out to Coach Vorse for doing that. It's just such a great thing. Ball's good, and Allen's going to the hole.
Rossford foul number 5, Jamari Kroom.
Yeah, it's Jamari's second foul right there. And
Hunter Allen at the line shooting one.
Hunter Allen missed. Easy three-point play right there. Jake Morrison playing a little bit tonight. Jake did a wonderful job in the JV game tonight. They won that 85-17. Jake puts a three up and nails it.
Morrison for three.
I don't know. I want to find out what the Morrison boys eat for breakfast. I really do, because I want that same cereal. And we got a timeout. Knew that was going to happen. We'll be right back right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Moe's Place, downtown Rossford, has the best burgers in town and much, much more. Stop by for their famous Flaming Moe Burger. Moe's Place, proud to bring you Rossford High School Sports.
Burn down for what? Don't forget tomorrow from 8 to noon, we're on ESPN 106.5, The Ticket. Nothing but terrible sports. 8 to noon, we're at the Toledo Golf Show out of Tam O'Shanter. And it is my second funnest week of the year. The first funnest is the marathon, because we're live out at the marathon on the first or the 10th tee. And we have such a good time with that. And tomorrow, I know Denny Schaefer's going to be with us. Tim Morrison's going to be with us. Anybody that has anything to do with golf, because here's the deal with golf in Toledo. If you're in the game of golf and you're Grandpa gets the slam. Nice. That was nice. We got a whistle here. But if you're in radio or if you're in media, 9 times out of 10, you don't pay for golf because you're in media, right? So, you know, I got Denny Schaefer, you know, Tim Morrison, all these guys, they're just great super-duper guys, and they'll be coming in to do their part to promote golf because that's what we're trying to do. And Andrew Brown's got a wonderful, wonderful thing. Come out to Tam O'Shanter. Please sit down with us. Say hello and be a part of everything that's going on here. That's a nice three. That's a nice looking three right there. Oh, beautiful. Oh. Now he got it taken away. Ethan got him. Oops. They're playing patty cake there. It didn't work that time. Koenig brings it up for the Wildcats. He's going to keep it. Bulldogs in that hardcore man-to-man right now, and it just makes it so tough to make anything happen inside. And then, you know, Behringer's getting it in there, but how they got to give it to him quick on that. There's Hunt for three, short. Koenig with the rebound inside, beautiful.
Jump ball possession here at Rossford.
That ball's going back to Rossford here. And 5:35 left to go. 19-11 is our score. Murph for another one. Uh-oh. That is the man you do not want to get hot if you're a Woodmore fan right now. 22-11. That's his second. Oh, Murph. Murph got him. Of course, he's saying he didn't get him. His dad's an attorney, so maybe he's going to use some of that attorney. Nah, it didn't work.
Andrew Behringer with the line, two shots.
Kent's a dear friend of mine. He's one of our play-by-play guys, and he's just a super great guy. He's been Murphy and Lewandowski attorneys. Great, great people. And sponsors here, Rex Murph. Rex Huffman, another great sponsor in helping us do this. Of course, Brad Morrison and all the great people. And Moe's Tavern got us on live right now. Behringer gets the second one. And I heard it. Timeout. They got a timeout. We'll be right back. We'll keep everything going. We'll be right back.
Hi there. I'm Nick with A-Plus Building Maintenance, your Toledo handyman. Do you need home repairs done? Not sure who to call? Here at A-Plus, we install everything from light bulbs to roofing. We're fully licensed and insured to protect you. We're also a proud member of the BBB. Please visit us online at ToledoHandyman.com. There you can see many before and after photos along with other customer testimonials and ask your own home repair question. Any job, big or small, A-Plus Building Maintenance, 419-478-1542.
Hey, everybody. That's my Mick Gonzalez. Had to get my Mick Gonzalez in there. 22-12. Mike Jamison with you here. We got Glenn Forbush on camera, and he's our historian too. He's the Rosford historian for the night too. So Morrison walking away as that one went up. That is called some definitely know what I'm going to do kind of stuff. Beautiful shot there, Ben. Behringer gets one. Well, yeah, that's with all the threes we've been seeing tonight, and boy, you got both the Morrisons on the floor right now, freshman and sophomore. And then you got Murph, three for Murph. Yeah, the fires are getting lit. Good time of the year to get a fire lit. Stole by Jake Morrison. Borvich in, and he gets it out to Murph. He's going for four. Oh, not that time. They're playing patty cake right there. They get it in. Ethan got it. And in a blink, they're up big. That's a full timeout. We'll take one too. Toledo Sports Network's proud to bring you this game right here.
When the power goes out, your life is disrupted. Heat, air conditioning, refrigeration, phones, all gone. Want to take back control? A Generac Home Standby Generator protects your home against power outages every second of every day, all year long, automatically, whether you're home or away. Control your power, control your life with a Generac Home Standby Generator.
For a free estimate, call Schneider Sons Electric, 419-691-8284.
And we're back. Mike Jamison here. 30-14 is our score. All of a sudden, in a blink, Rossford's been able to put quite a couple of points on the board quickly inside there. That's that inside-out game that they do. And they're just at the right place, right time. They know what to do with the basketball. And quick scores right there. Hey, don't forget tomorrow night, spaghetti dinner. It's going to be over at the I want to make sure I get this right. It's on the board right now. So I think it's either at the VFW. I'll know here in a second. And they got 50-50 raffles, wine pull, baked goods for sale. It's going to be a great time for the Rossford Band. And it is at the Rossford Eagles, 658 Lime City Road. And Woodmore is able to get it up, but Ben Morrison, once again, inside, his ability to be in the right place at the right time in that court is just incredible. Just incredible. 30-14 is our score. Another one. Ben tips it away. He's quicker than Glenn Forbush on a Moe Burger. Too soon? I don't know. Sorry, I just. I'm probably going to go home and eat a dollar frozen pizza for dinner here tonight. You know, it's. Gadsden with it up top, slowing things down here for the Bulldogs. I'm sure that won't last very long. They'll move it around. They got him and Murph up at the top of the key. Grandpa, there he is. DeWeese. Ethan DeWeese pops it in. Two more. He's having a nice night tonight. 7 points tonight. Ben's got eight. Nine for... look that over here. We got Murph in... 9 points, three threes. Jake Morrison's back in for the hometown Bulldogs. They bring it up. Just such a phenomenal place to watch basketball. I just hope and pray I don't upset somebody because I want to sit in this perch for the next 20 years. This is going to be my place when I'm old and gray. When Ben Morrison and... comes back here just to say it after his NBA career, you know, or DeWeese.
For three.
And then And they're clicking tonight. They're clicking tonight. They're getting the open look and doing what they need to do with it here, and it really looks good. Hunt's got it right now. He's going to pop a three. That doesn't look bad. Borovich over to freshman Morrison.
Jake Morrison.
Morrison's are having a good time tonight. That looks good.
Andrew Behringer. Ross McCollum, number 23, Luke Borovich. His second personal, team's fifth. Into the lineup for Woodmore, number 4, Brad Miller.
Borovich with the foul. Allen's back. And Brad Miller looks like DJ Melter's coming in too. Gosh, you know, we made it over 14,000 people on our YouTube views in the past 90 days, and about 8,000 of that's been the last 3 weeks. It's just incredible. Thank you so much. It's just nice to know that everybody said we couldn't do it or we suck at it, and it's just nice to know that it's good. And it's because of people like Ethan DeWeese right there just popping it up. 40-14 right now. Oh, I'm sorry, 40-16. I want to make sure I get all those scores in there. I didn't see that one. Nice hands straight up and did it exactly how you're supposed to do it there. And that's Gavin DeWeese. Nice job. Morrison's going to take a three again. He missed that one. But Gavin got it. Jake's going for, ooh, that was a little long. Just a bit outside. Kind of like my drive. It's got a little tail to it, you know. Can't do anything with it. Allen, nothing. Brad Miller. Yeah, you got to put that three in. Nothing there. I'll bet you that's on Gavin. Yeah.
Ross for Colin, number 4, Gavin Ruiz. His first personal, team 6. Returning to the Whitmore lineup, number 13, DJ Melter. This is the last call for 50-50 tickets out in the main lobby.
Melter in again for the Woodmore Wildcats. Don't forget these guys. Rossford plays Saturday night at Genoa. And the winner of the Oak Harbor Woodward game. No, it's already done. I must be doing something wrong. Glenn's looking at me. So I thought Oak Harbor... They're playing Oak Harbor. No, we don't know yet. Ethan DeWeese for another three. Boy, my historian Glenn Forbush and I are going to have a long talk here at halftime. Oh, he's texting it to me now. So Glenn's one of them guys, he does it all. He, you know, he runs camera, takes pictures, takes video for his camera. He washes my car. Cleans the inside out every once in a while. I'm just teasing. He does not do that. I would never let Glenn do that. Bentoncourt in for Wildcats. Oh.
Cast in.
45-16 is our score right now, and that was almost an ankle breaker right there. Gadsden is just so quick. And they get the ball back. 45-16, they got the ball back, and we're looking at 33 seconds left to go here in the half. Gavin, they get it over to Jake. Gadsden, three people. Woodmore's putting some good D on right now. And Gavin, nice turn. Beautiful, beautiful. Folks, that's the sophomore version of the DeWeese family. And so you're going to be seeing him for a long time. Hey, get it up. And just a bit outside. 4.8 seconds. See if they're going to do anything here, and sure are. Oh, hot hand, Deweese. Got it. You should get four for that one, folks. That was so far out. That was a beautiful shot. Our halftime score, 50-16 right now. We'll be back with more right here on the Toledo Sports Network. Stick around.
What can you expect from working with Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation? Our branch manager, Marty Binn, can help you navigate through the loan process with the service and speed you deserve. Contact Marty today to get pre-qualified. Make your home buying dreams a reality. Call 419-481-8696 to speak with Marty Binn today.
Our roster boys statistician is Ken Sutter. Our stat person on the scoreboard, Jackson Murtha. Clock operator, Hunter Hitchens. Official scorekeeper, Janet Madden. And running our music this year is Dave Misko. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, on behalf of the Rossford High School and the Athletic Hall of Fame Selection Committee, it is our pleasure to welcome you to Rossford High School Athletic Hall of Fame Induction Ceremony. The Athletic Hall of Fame recognizes and honors the achievement of athletes, coaches, school officials, and at-large community members who, through their commitment and dedication, have made outstanding contributions to Rossford High School athletics and have brought pride and distinction to our school and community. Today we are pleased to present our 30th class for induction into the Athletic Hall of Fame. It is with great honor and pride that we recognize Mr. Wilson Beard, class of 1977, Mr. Jason Durden, class of 1990, and Mr. Tommy Kralovic, class of 2009. As they join 140 Rossford High School Athletic Hall of Fame members. Ladies and gentlemen, our first inductee this evening is Mr. Wilson Beard. Wilson was a fundamental part of the Tisdale family athletic legacy at Rossford High School. He was a talented standout in football, basketball, and track. Notably, he was the Northern Lakes League 100-yard and 220-yard dash champion and rushed for 1,121 yards in just 5 games during an injured senior season. He went on to attend the University of Findlay, where he led the Oilers to runner-up and national championship football seasons in 1978 and 1979. After a tryout with the New England Patriots, he moved to Phoenix, Arizona, where he met his wife, Linda. He worked for Sears Holding Corporation, volunteered his time helping others as a peer support specialist for the National Alliance on Mental Illness, and authored a book entitled Stop the Stigma on Mental Illness. His passing has made an indelible impact on his friends and family, and our hope is that his memory will be honored by an increased awareness of mental illness. Accepting Mr. Beard's plaque on his behalf this evening are his siblings, Mr. Ronald Rocky Tisdale and Mrs. Beverly Beard Page. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause for our first inductee this year, Mr. Wilson Beard. our second inductee is Mr. Jason Durbin. Jason Durbin is the son of Frank and Henrietta Durbin. Jason was a standout football player and was on two state playoff teams as a sophomore and senior. During his career, Jason accumulated over 3,000 all-purpose yards and 25 touchdowns. As a junior, he set a school record when he returned a kickoff for 101 yards against Bowling Green, and as a senior, he led the Bulldogs to a Northern Lakes League title and a state playoff berth. Jason also led the NLL in rushing with 1,014 yards and scoring with 16 touchdowns. For his efforts, he received first team All-Northern Lakes League, first team All-Metro, first team All-District, and special mention, All-Ohio. Jason was highly noted for his incredible strength as he was a member of the Rossford High School 300-pound bench press club. He was also a key member of the track team. After graduating, Jason continued his playing career at North Iowa College, where he was a key part of winning two league titles and two RC Cola Bowls. Before graduating from North Iowa, Jason set school bench press records with a 500-pound bench and doing 225 pounds for 47 reps. Jason went on to finish his career at the University of Cincinnati, where he was set to be a key part of their program until he suffered a devastating knee injury. Once he recovered, Jason went on to attend several pro combine camps in hopes to play professionally. He received an offer to play over in Europe and Canada, but re-injured his knee and ended his career. Jason is a successful business owner and resides in Rossford with his family. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jason Durbin. Our third inductee this evening is Tommy Kralovic. Is the son of Tom Kralovic and Luann Kralovic, and brother of Tyler Kralovic, class of 2010. Tommy graduated from Rossford in 2009. While Tommy was a student at Rossford High School, he was on the honor roll all 4 years and attained the Athletic Boosters Academic Award his sophomore, junior, and senior years of high school. Tommy also had the honor of receiving the Promethean Award his junior year and was a member of the NLL Senior All-Academic Team his senior year. During his freshman year, Tommy was captain of the football team and a varsity starter on the basketball team. During his sophomore year, he developed a passion for golf and decided to join the RHS golf team. He achieved multiple NLL and All-District honorable mentions and helped lead the Bulldogs to the 2009 sectional championship. During all 4 years of high school, Tommy's true passion remained on the basketball court. He played varsity his freshman through senior year, where he started all but one game. He was named team captain his junior and senior year. While playing basketball, Tommy received many awards of recognition. Freshman through junior year, these awards included honorable mention, District 7, second team, Northern Lakes League, first team, District 7, and honorable mention, Associated Press, Division II. As a senior, he earned first team Northern Lakes League, first team District, first team All Wood County, All Blade Basketball Top 25, and received the Ohio High School Basketball Coaches Association Scholarship Society Gold Certificate. During his senior year, Tommy became the seventh player in Rossford High School history to score 1,000 career points. Tommy went on to play at Owens Community College and then graduated in 2014 from Bowling Green State University with a bachelor's degree in supply chain management. While earning his degree at BGSU, Tommy was the assistant coach for the Rossford JV boys basketball team, where they won two league titles. After graduation, Tommy relocated to Cleveland, Ohio, but will always call Rossford home. Ladies and gentlemen, Tommy Kralovic. Ladies and gentlemen, please join us in celebrating these fine athletes for their achievement and their devotion to Rossford High School athletics. Congratulations, Wilson, Jason, and Tommy.
Swing by the Toledo Golf Show at Tam O'Shanter, February 21st to 23rd. Come practice your swing in a state-of-the-art golf simulator. Try craft beers and register to win prizes, including free rounds of golf. Visit ToledoGolfShow.com for more info.
about ready to start the third quarter here. Mike Jamison with you here at the Toledo Sports Network. Let me see. I'm going to push a button and tell you exactly what the score is. Look at that. 50-16 is our score as we get ready to start the third quarter here. Brought to you in part by Michael J. Weiss and MJ Weiss Roofing Company. You know, they put this whole span on here and did a wonderful job and a great contracted commercial roofing company here in town there in Millbury, Ohio, right on Main Street there, 28349. Their office is 419-836-3028. And Michael is a roofing and sheet metal contractor and a proud supporter of what we're trying to do here for Rossford basketball. And thank you, Michael, and we really appreciate it. And right now you've got Murph out there. You've got Mr. Perry out there. You got Ethan. And number 24, Hayden Sabowick. And I just dig him. And Cameron Gatson. That ball stolen. Ethan gets it up to Gatson. And I thought he might not be able to get there, but he did. They're moving it around. Murph. How about it? Hayden Sabovic with his first 2 points of this contest tonight. There's real excitement when that happens. I know Dad's proud of him, and he's a good kid too, really good kid. All these kids are good, and they just love the game of basketball, and they're part of what this game really needs. And it's a resurgence for the Rossford area, and beautiful digs now to do what they need to do, and Coach Vorst, Morrison, Kralovic, and all of these gentlemen, they just do such a wonderful, wonderful job with these kids. And Mr. Reitz, they're all Jonathan, they're all great, just great guys, and become some of my dearest friends. And they just got a hardcore ability to make these kids work hard and do something really good with the game. Oh! Gadsden laughed on that one, but that looked scary for a second. You always, when somebody gets upstairs like that, you get a little nervous. Ethan, all the way over. They get it in to Hayden. Murph's going to pop another one. Little short, going to get it back. Looks inside to Ethan. Over to Walker. Actually, it's Nick Perry. I'm sorry. So far, Rossford's basically been able to do whatever they want right now. And I know Woodmore's trying to maybe, keep the ball a little bit more on their side. Nice inside. Beautiful job. Behringer getting one. 52-20 right now. Hayden. Sabovic. Over to Murph. Looks good. Up. Oh, Ethan. Hardcore rebound right there.
Ethan DeWeese.
54-20. Got it. Looks like that foul's going to be on Hayden.
Basket's good for Aaron Miller. Ross the foul number 24. Hayden Sabovic, his first personal. Teams first in the second half.
Nice shot right there, Aaron Miller.
Ethan DeWeese
is just a freaking three-point magnet right now. He is just in fuego when it comes to shooting that. I don't know if I can say that or not. Well, we're on ESPN tomorrow. I guess I can say that. Gadsden got him. Gadsden is just so quick. His defense is just incredible. And the one thing he does, even if he gets burnt on the side, he leads people over to where there is another defender, and it's just incredible what he's able to do with that. Good job, Gadsden. We'll be seeing him a lot next year. And –
That's Hayden.
Roster foul number 24, Hayden Samovic. His second personal, team second. Andrew Behringer at the line.
Behringer here. Got a chance to get a couple. Way short, first one. Didn't take his time. You got to back off. Take a big deep breath. Then you shoot. I didn't score very much, but when I did score, it was because I was at the foul line with one eye hanging out. Oh, short on both. Gadsden with the rebound. They're going to bring it up. Oh. Him and Ethan been working on that for a long time. Normally, he makes those. Nice. Behringer gets it.
Andrew Behringer.
Get it in. Oh, in and out for Hayden. Nice looking shot, though. Love it. Camaraderie. I just love it. Oh, yes. Hayden gets a nice rebound right there. Gets it up to Murph. Murph's going to split it. Get it over to Gadsden. Gadsden's going to the hole. And gets it. That is just money. Absolute money right there. 58-25 with about 3:44 left. Allen, look good. Grandpa gets another rebound. Over to Gadsden. Gadsden, oh, that's Murph. Oh, how about that? Nick Perry with a beautiful pickup and got to bring it up to 60 right there. Nice job, Nick. Murph gets it. Gadsden's going to take the three. Missed. Looks like Miller with the rebound there, and he trips. Gadsden gets it, and there's that Everybody on the floor on that one.
Whitmore foul number one, Zach Hunt, his second personal.
Zach Hunt with the foul there for Woodmore Wildcats. First one's up. Ethan drills it. Nice to see the foul shots going in tonight. Don't forget, tomorrow we'll be at the golf show. Tam O'Shanter from 8 till noon. If you're coming out, please come out, you know, during our hours and sit down and shoot the poop with us. We love it. You know how we get. And we have a lot of fun, all the great people. And we want to just talk to everyday golfers about the game, along with some of the wonderful, wonderful people that are going to be part of what's part of Andrew Brown and his gang, and Richard and everybody have just done such a phenomenal job with putting this together. And Ethan with another rebound. He's splitting it. He's going to run the point here, and he's going to get it over to Ben. Ethan Ben in now, out to Ethan DeWeese.
Oh. Ethan DeWeese for three.
All right, I'm going to give you a number here in just a second, folks. It's Ethan DeWeese dash 29 points already tonight.
Tonight's winning 50-50 ticket number is 357-590.
Borovich bringing it up now for the Bulldogs. Once again, next Friday night, they'll be playing the winner of Woodward and Woodward Oak Harbor. Ben Morrison with a steal. Ethan!
DeWeese.
DeWeese with 31 now. 150 left to go here in the third quarter. Just having a career night. Allen pops one. It's a little bit off. Ethan, another rebound. Gets it over to Ben Morrison. Over to Borovich. And he misses. And that's one of the first times he's missed. And he, oh, they call jump ball there. Jump ball. Morrison and Jamari Kroom in now. Take care, guys. Be good. 67-25 is our score. I'm sorry, 68. I missed one. tickled it there and didn't tell me. Ben pops it just off the rim just a bit. At this point, if you're Woodmore, you want to keep that ball on your side of the court as long as you possibly can. You got 1:06 left to go. You want to get it down to the last possible, or Jamari Kroom gets it over to Jake Morrison, and Jake don't miss either. I think the Morrison family should have their own glue, you know. They don't miss, you know, and ooh. I don't know what they'd call it. If I had a cohort here, they'd tell me what they called it. But like I said, Woodmore needs to hold on to the ball. It's going to stay here. Yeah, it's going to stay here with the Wildcats. Be 12 degrees warmer. We're looking at 47, 48 degrees tomorrow, folks. So enjoy your weekend. If you'd like to come down and buff my boat out, there'll be a six-pack of Diet Mountain Dew there for you. I'm actually going to be in Port Clinton most of the day tomorrow, looking over the beautiful, beautiful Lake Erie, and get ready for our Lake Erie Port of Call show, and enjoying some free time up there. Hunt with it. Yeah, they just... get caught. I don't even know what to call that, folks. But done with three here. 70-25 is our score. We will be right back for the fourth quarter on the Toledo Sports Network.
Mike Jamison and Jamison's Mobile Music would like to talk to you about your entertainment needs for your upcoming wedding or special event. For over 25 years, Mike has made wonderful memories one event at a time. Professional sound and lighting and video for your special event. Call us today for an affordable package for your special day. 419-514-1302. Jamison's Mobile Music and Video.
Big round of applause going out. The athletic boosters just put a $11,000 check in the hands of Chris and everybody here to pay for that beautiful scoreboard you're looking at right now. That is LED scoreboard that is just incredible, and just does a lot of great things here, and it's just a great way to promote what this town has done, and promote all of the wonderful people that are coming together as just a wonderful group and make good things happen here. Fourth quarter right now, 70-25, and I think at this point it's Woodmore's got to make some things happen and get some three-point shooting. If they're going to do that, you got to pop it. There it is. Hunt, short, nice rebound. Bobka with the rebound. You got a foul, talking about it. How about that chicken sandwich I had today? Wasn't that great? Sorry. Oh, we got a technical.
Technical foul assist for Rossford's number 4, Gavin DeWeese.
Gavin DeWeese got that mob mentality tonight. Boy, he's the scrapper. I think what they need to do on these technical shots, I think they just need to bring their dad out there and whoop him on the butt for one. Tell I'm kind of tired right now. The second one's up. No, I don't want people to think that I'm in for capital punishment or something here. Even though I am, but, you know, it is what it is.
And then the Wade man comes up. He walks right by me. Smart man. Wade walks by. True dog for life. Some of the younger guys in now. Hunt takes it all the way to the hole. He pops it out to Miller. Brad Miller's got it now, and he's going to probably take. Nope. Thought he was going to take that shot. Nice move to the hole. Beautiful shot right there. Zach Hunt with it. Yeah. Little busy tonight, huh? Borovich with it. In and out. And once again, Zach Hunt with it.
Isaac Bentoncourt for three.
Bentoncourt pops a three right there. And a timeout.
Returning to the Whitmore lineup, number 24, Kate Burrows.
Kate Burrows in for the Whitmore Wildcats. Got Ethan Binn in there. Oh, Grandma and Grandpa down in Florida right now are happy about that. Borovich, going to move it around. Jake, back to Borovich. Borovich is a really, really good ball handler. Walker gets it over to Linkus, and no, in and out. Borovich gets it left. How about that? Luke Borovich right there. Oh, somebody got popped right there. And Kate Burrows. Once again, I want to get special thanks out to Michael Weiss and Weiss Roofing. They're over there on Main Street in Millbury, Ohio, and they had the pleasure and very proud of the fact that they put this wonderful, wonderful roof on this this wonderful facility here. And Michael's been a part of commercial contracting, roofing, and sheet metal for many, many years. 836-3028. Can't thank him enough for helping us bring you these games. They're looking. Hunt wants to take it. It's not gonna. Him and Sandrock taking it over on the sides there. They get it back over to Bentoncourt. Bentoncourt takes the shot in. Beautiful shot. 72-33 is our score right now. Final regular season game for us here. We're definitely going to be doing the boys. Rossford boys will be taking on either Woodward or Oak Harbor next Friday night. And Walker, strong, and there's a foul. He's going to the line. 4:59 left to go in this one.
One more foul.
Nick beat him up Walker. Nick Babyface. No, he's Nick Babyface Walker, right? That's what it is. Yeah, yeah. Scares the hell out, the hell out of me too.
So. Rossford substitution number 30.
Nick can be a runaway train at times, and I just would not want to be the car that got stuck on those tracks and couldn't start the engine and get away from it. Just saying. Gare Murphy is in right now. You got Ben in there, Walker, Jake, and you got all the Murphs in there right now.
Also returning to the Russell Lent, number zero, Ben Morrison.
73-34 is our score right there. I want to make sure we get it right. Got a lot of new Woodward or Woodmore people coming in here. One of the JVs, lefty shot. Ben Morrison with it.
I think Ben's going to run the point, give it to his brother, and not going to happen. Whoa.
Back in for Woodmore, number two, Paul Koenig, number 30, Andrew Berenger, number 5, Ethan McNair, and number 25, Hunter Allen. And for Rossmer, number 25, Alex Williams.
Alex Williams in the game. Looking at most of the JV team in there now with Ben. And he got it.
Ben Morrison.
Sandrock. He tries to go the hole. He's going to get fouled. Get some of these names in here. Hunter Allen, of course, is in there.
Rossman called number zero. Ben
Andrew Berenger. Paul Koenig and Ethan McNair.
Back into the roster lineup, number 32, Nick Perry. 24, Hayden Savova. And number 3, Ethan DeWeese.
Got it. Looks like we got a timeout, and we'll be right back.
Roster timeout, 30-second timeout.
Founded in 1936, Spittler Huffman is proud to continue our long-standing tradition of providing quality results and effective legal services to clients all across Northwest Ohio. We solve problems. That has been our motto for more than 78 years. Be it simple or complex, our attorneys work hard to give you the representation you deserve. We also believe in and support the respective communities in which we live and practice law.
.75-36 is our score with about 4 minutes left to go here. Mike Jamison. Hayden gets the rebound. How about that kid? He walked. Woodmore ball. 3:50 left. I appreciate you guys sitting in. I'm looking on our server company here and seeing how many people we had, a bunch of people on tonight. Thank you, thank you. Just they've been short on all of their threes in the second half. Ethan a little slow getting up, but he's all right. Oh, beautiful shot there by Allen. Nice shot. Hunter Allen got a nice shot there. .75-39. Oh, he's going to take it. No, not that time. Alex Williams trying to get that one in there. One of my favorites of the kids that are coming up, freshmen. It's going to be exciting to watch them. Ball is coming back.
Rossford substitution number 13, Ethan Benn replacing number 24, Hayden Samoa. Also number 4, Gavin DeWeese. Replacing number 3, Ethan DeWeese. Number 10, Garrett Murphy.
Garrett Murphy in here.
Replacing number 30, Reed Murphy. And number 20, Gavin Linkus. Replacing number 32, Nick Perry.
Wonderful game for these Bulldogs tonight. They played their hearts out. The three-point shooting was phenomenal. And it's just been one of those great, great nights if you're a Bulldog fan. Glenn's done a wonderful job on camera. Till that. But, can't give you a 100% compliment, you know. It's stolen. Link is with it. He's going to get it out to Ethan Benn. Nice job. Oh. Alex Williams with three. Remember that name, folks, the next couple of years. He's a freshman, and he's a really, really fun ball player to watch. 1:53 left to go in this contest. Keep trying that little dump-off play, and Gavin Williams or somebody inside there just kind of waits till that starts to happen, and the next thing you know, old Jed's a millionaire. Williams misses that one. Probably should have got hit for traveling on that one, but I think the refs put the whistles away for the evening unless something bad happens. Like the shot. There you go. That's a nice shot, Aaron Miller. Miller, 42-78. About a minute. Ben puts one up, doesn't go, and misses. Ben gets the rebound. This one's going to go over to Murph. Murph's going to pop the three. My brother can do it. My brothers, I can do it. Oh, whoa, that is definitely got to be. That has got to be. It's got to be something. You don't want it to be, but it's got to be. Yeah, he's done. Coach Claus just said, nah.
Oh, it is. Second personal, team's third.
You just get a little upset, you know, it just happens. It just happens, you know.
At the line for Rossford, shooting two, number 25, Alex Williams.
Alex got popped on that one. He's got two plus the ball, so. First one's up, and just not going to make it. Second one's up, and missed them both. Intentional foul, they get the ball back. And we'll have this game up on YouTube tomorrow, folks. So, you know, become a friend of mine over there on Facebook or, you know, Toledo Sports Network or YouTube, especially YouTube. We've got over 600 people on YouTube now. Garrett Murphy popping the three. I'm telling you, this DeWeese family and this Murphy family, I want to see what they eat for breakfast. There has been some serious, serious threes. Ben's taking it all the way to the hole and scoring. That's how you do it, buddy. All the way in.
Aaron Miller.
Aaron Miller for the... Wildcats right there, and we're down, and that's going to be it tonight. Folks, a phenomenal game for the Rossford Bulldogs here, getting themselves tuned up. Final game of the year, and they're all tuned up, getting themselves ready for tournament play, which will start next Friday night at Genoa as they get ready for their stuff. They're going to be cutting down the nets tonight. I am assuming this is for the NBC Championship. Right, Glenn? There we go. They're going to be cutting down these nets, and boy, I'll tell you what, this team has just lit the fire, and you know, all of the coaches have done a wonderful job. They know the game very well. You know, Kralovic, Morrison, of course, Mr. Vorts. They, all of these guys, not to mention, you know, it's just, I'm looking down at them right now. They're just a great, great, great bunch of guys, and Reitz, and just all of these guys have just done a wonderful job at making sure that these kids play well and they've got good hearts. And it's just proud to be a part of it. Folks, I am Mike Jamison with Toledo Sports Network. We will have some more basketball for you next week. Make sure you just check us out on Facebook and stuff. And we'll have this game for you up tomorrow. Your final again. The Rossford Bulldogs 83, Woodmore Wildcats 44. Big thanks going out to Glenn Forbush doing our camera tonight. He's doing a really, really good job for us. And folks, have a wonderful week. And don't forget, tomorrow from 8 to noon, we're going to be over at the Golf Show on ESPN 106.5 The Ticket. If you can listen, please do, and enjoy yourselves. And folks, we will see you later. God bless, and have a wonderful day.